Meyer, American Fire Company, number one, Lansford, Pennsylvania. This Ahrens-Fox was in service for 45 years. Six-cylinder, 1100cc, and the telltale Ahrens-Fox bubble on top of the pumper engine. You could suck some water out of a river with that and pump it onto the flames. This beauty was in service for 45 years. And it only has 4,000 and change miles. What a beauty. Made in Cincinnati, Ohio. Ahrens-Fox. Playing some good music here. Ring that dinner bell. Ahrens-Fox. Model BT. Cincinnati, Ohio. Patented June 27th, 1916. What a beast. Armstrong power steering and brakes. Brakes and a three-speed. No top, no tonneau cover, no convertible roof or umbrella. I don't think we work on those rhino ramps. Oak. And a big ladder, a hook and ladder truck. Spotlights, this baby was in service for 45 years. Built to last, only 4,000 miles. Armstrong power steering. Wow, needed a big guy to drive this beast. What a beauty. Six cylinder, 18 spark plugs, magneto and battery ignition. Original cost $13,750 in 1937. If you look underneath, better on underneath than on top. What an engine, huh? What a gearbox. Holy Toledo. The gearbox is 6 feet long. It's got a 6 foot long gearbox.
Wow. Beast.
Wow. Oh, wait, that's the engine. No, wait, that's the engine. This is the pumper engine up front.
There's teeth in the back here spinning around.
Flywheel. Yeah, the engine is 6 feet long. The engine is 6 feet long. The pumper.
Six cylinder engine?
Yeah, look how long that crankshaft is. That crankshaft probably weighs 1,000 pounds.
It's a beast. It's a
gearbox is way back there.
Cast iron beast.
Yeah, even the brackets for the running boards are cast. This ain't no toy.
No beast.
6 foot long engine. Just this engine alone must weigh 10,000 pounds. I'm not even sure what I'm looking at, but this is quite the monster.
The rear end's upside down. It's got the
drive-in from the top.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that before.
I've never seen that.
Yeah. Yep. Look at that sewer pipe exhaust.
I know it.
You think you got a Cummins with a sewer pipe exhaust? Look at the transmission. They drive this thing. It's leaking oil.
Yep.
Vacuum brakes. Is that what that is? Vacuum canister for the brakes.
Oh, yeah. Look at that rear end upside down. I wonder why they did that.
Here's where the siren is.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Once in a while you see one of these sitting in the junkyard in the field or something, or
at
auction.
How do you move this thing around?
I don't want to be a monstrosity. Like, it's a beast. This went cross country on a flatbed trailer out here.
Yeah, big flatbed trailer.
Come from Ohio.
Yeah, it's got big brakes.
Pennsylvania, and then it headed out this way.
Yeah.
Spotlights, several spotlights. It's quite the spotlight with a bulb on it. It's like,
No LEDs there. No projector HID headlamp. Front. Somebody had to polish. Make and polish that ladder. Put the stays, the rungs and the stays together. Oh, there's that big differential. Yeah. Those big brakes.
Upside down when you're tall or something.
Yeah. Wow, what a beast. It's a serious fire truck.
What's the protection sticker say about the gear?
1981.
It was on the road in 81. And then she's
82.
Retired
Pennsylvania. American Fire Company, Lansford, Pennsylvania. Gold leaf lettering.
Ooh.
What do you think of this Lamborghini here with that clothes drying shelf. You can hang out your shorts and your sheets.
On the towel rack. Or a hot tub and wrap your towel around it, your bathing suit, and jump in and...
They had that on the Dodge Daytona and the Plymouth Superbird back in 1970.
I know, it's so out of place, man. It's like, I mean, the Monte Carlo guy has a small one on the trunk, but that's probably just about good enough.
Ahrens-Fox. This is where you kept your lunch. There's even a lunch box holder.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, while you're putting up the fire, you have to have a snack.
Ahrens-Fox. Yep.
Through the spotlight.
Cheese and crackers and
the light from Mars. U.S. patented since a Canadian patent. Mars Signal Light Company, Chicago, Illinois. Somebody polished that baby. They stamped it and put it all together and polished her up. Every handle, every nut and bolt, everything was made with care by somebody on an assembly line. Double spring, heavy duty. Ashcroft, American. What a beauty. Look at that radiator. Cast. What a truck.
Yeah.
John Ahrens and Charlie Fox. Crazy.
Engine has a
1,000
gallons per minute front pump.
1,000 gallons per minute. The Ahrens-Fox Fire Engine Company is an Ohio-based fire truck manufacturer founded in 1910 by John P. Ahrens and Charles H. Fox. This 1937 Ahrens was in use in 37 as the American Fire Company Engine Number 1, Lansford, Pennsylvania. 1,000 gallon per minute pump. Ahrens-Fox fire engines were recognizable by the chrome sphere on the pump that was used to hold air and smooth the outgoing pressure in the accumulator from the pump. On September 18, 2014, Joe Janicek came to the Marconi Museum and was reunited with the actual Ahrens-Fox fire engine that he operated a little over 40 years ago. Six-cylinder, 1,100 cubic inch.
0-60.
Yeah.
No comment.
We'll get to the fire on time. That's all that matters. Get to the fire on time and save the downtown.
0-60, no comment. We should get going, so we're going to be driving up
the Ferrari.
I've seen them all. I've seen them all.
And Lamborghinis and Mustang GTs and Cadillacs and Rolls Royces. And what else we got here? Hidden in the back room, the aft room, 56 Cadillac and a 1957 Cadillac Coupe de Ville. The front one's an El Dorado. And the back one is a Coupe de Ville with a bunch of beauties. 73 four-speed, 351 Cleveland, a 340 Cuda, a Marco 250, Simplex race car, a Gullwing Mercedes. Paul Anka. That's too many. GT500 428 with police interceptor engine. Yep. It says C6, but it's got a four-speed and a 427 in that one, side over with two 4-barrels, I believe. GT500. Yep, Carroll Shelby was out of the picture in a 440 six-pack Challenger, longer wheelbase than the Cuda Barracuda. Ferraris and Back to the Future, John DeLorean, the head of Pontiac, didn't get promoted to the chief of General Motors, so out the door he went and he made the Back to the Future. Sharp car with a Peugeot Citroën engine. Ferraris and Mustangs and Prowlers. Ford GT that took a drive on one of those once. It was a bumpy road. We couldn't open her up. Those sell for more now than they did when they were new. Love it. Love the fire engine. Viper. I got into one of those. It don't fit. Not big enough. Too much engine. V10. Too extreme. 66 Corvette, 427, 425 horsepower, solid lifter, teak wood wheel. I love this museum. Glad we came here. We're going to head back to Palm Springs and have a nightcap. Beauties. Love them all. What a great collection. Thank you, Mr. Marconi. It was worth the drive. Too bad you can't buy the Prowler anymore, or luckily you can't buy the Prowler, but Chip Boost Hemisphere. or Jaguar 73X E-Type. First year for the V12, 71, this is a 73. Just in time for American pollution controls. This has got almost knockoff wheels, no knockoff gears. Put a special wrench on. V12. Love it.